Hi friends, in today's video we are going to see how to make this butterfly assembly. For that we have to first make this part of butterfly whose name is body. For that we will make first two these cages. Now let's start it. First go on start, then mechanical design and then part design. After that select one plane, then go on sketch option. After that make two circles first. Let's give it diameter. Diameter of inner circle is given as 194 and diameter of outer circle is given as 140 into 2. After that go on exit to workbench and then use this pad command. Now you can see here the length is given as 225, but we will give it 225 divided by 2 because we want to make just half part. So and we will mirror it. So let's give it as 225 divided by 2. 25. After that, select this cage option. Select this plane so we can sketch on it. Then select sketch option. After that first use this projection method and project this circle first. After that use this sketch option, make sketch as shown in figure. You can use it so you can make one half circle and then again take one circle here. After that first select this line, then use control option button, then this line and then use this central axis. Go on this constraint option and use symmetry to it. After that let's give dimensions to it. Radius of this is given as 50 and radius of inner circle is diameter of inner circle is given as 47. Then again distance between this axis to this point is given as 175 and enter it. After that our sketch is in green color, so it's fully constrained. Wait a second, we have to use trim command to trim extra circle and then go on exit to workbench. Use this pad command, use this reverse direction, so it will go inside the inside that circle. After that given thickness is 32, so make one preview and click on OK. After that select pad 2 from given tree diagram. After that select this pattern command, circular pattern command, and we want 3 circular patterns, so I'm selecting here 3 and degree is 360 divided by 3. After that select axis. We have to select axis. You can see here my axis is X, so I'm selecting X axis to here and making preview and then OK. Now we have to mirror this whole part to this surface. So select this whole part from here and then go on this mirror option and select surface and then click on OK. Now we have to create plane first. We want plane. We have to make plane first. So you can see here we want plane from the middle to the part which will be look like this. So I am taking this plane and creating one new plane from plane option. We want that plane to 160, at a distance of 160. You can see here the distance is given as 160. Here is 160. So 160, take one preview it's in opposite direction. I want it in opposite direction. So use this reverse direction and click on OK. Select that plane. Then again go on this sketch option. After that use this normal view and then make one circle first. Give diameter to it. Diameter of given circle is 200. And then go on exit to workbench again. Use this pad command. Select option up to surface. Select surface and then click on OK. After that we again want this plane. You can see here next plane we want from the center of it's 127 mm far from the center. So use this plane as a reference, then click on surface plane and the dimension is given as 175 and enter it. After that select that plane, go on go on sketch option and now make one circle of radius 75 as it is given in figure. After that again exit to workbench, then use this pad command, select option as up to surface and select this surface and click on OK. After that select this sketch, then again go on sketch option, make one circle there of given diameter, what's diameter it is 56 it's 56 56 and enter it. After that go on exit to workbench. You can see here this is the circle of diameter 56. The given length of that deepness is 310 from this surface to that end of the circle. So we have to give pocket command to it and its length must be 1010 and enter it. You can see here it is created. After that again select this surface, go on sketch option and then use this circle command again, make one circle of diameter 100 as it is given in figure and then again go on exit to workbench, use pocket command and write here 25 because it is given in figure. Now this is how we have completed our sketch assembly, and but one part is remaining. Select this surface, then go on sketch option. After that make one circle here of diameter 20.3 as it is given in figure, but we have to give PCD to it to locate its dimensions. First take circle and tick on the tick on the construction line, so your circle will be as a reference and dimension of this is given as 150. After that select center and circle, then go on this construction constraint box, then coincide option and click on OK. After that use this rotate command, select circle. After that select the point according to which you want to rotate your circle. Here I am giving 360 divided by 3 and selecting 2 here because we want more 2 circles, not 3, and then click on OK. After that go on exit to workbench and then use this pocket command again and given length is 25 as it is given in figure, then click on OK. This is how we have completed our base body from butterfly wall assembly. Thank you so much guys.